Welcome. We'll start with our next lecture where we'll be talking about how to attempt your online paper for your NTA examination. So NTA or National Testing Agency is your new body that would be conducting your exams, and this would be in your online mode. Now, what's the basic difference between online mode and a paper-based examination? I would say this method of NTA is much more advantageous because you would save your time. In the paper-based test, you had to spend some time on filling the OMR sheet. So I used to recommend students to leave at least 5 to 10 minutes to fill the OMR sheet towards the end. In this exam, there is no such thing that's required. So you would have all your 1 hour, for example, in your paper one, that would be dedicated to your paper solving. Now, a few of the very important things that you have to take care while you are attempting your NTA examination would be discussed in this class. Now, here we have an interface from Doorstep Tutor where we have tried to bring this very closer to your real NTA examination. So what you would do is you would go on to attempt test. In this lecture, we would be talking about only attempt test, that is the real NTA examination. However, if you go here, you would find solutions and explanations and the result in the analytics, which would be section wise and topic wise analysis for the scores for the test that you have done and your scores in specific topics, bringing out which of the topics were weak and which of the topics you were good at. So let's start with the attempt test. So let's go on to the test first and click attempt test. As soon as you do this, you would have a list of instructions that would come up. Now you would have certain signs that would be here. These signs are very, very important to understand. So questions that are not visited would be in this color. Then you had the questions that are not answered would be mentioned with this sign and this color. The question that you have answered would be in the specific format. Then you would have marked for review and answered and marked for review. So those two categories are different. Now, after you have read these set of instructions for your examination paper, you would click ready, begin the test now. As soon as you would click here, you would have your first test that would come up. So you have all the question numbers that are given here, okay? This would be the timer that would be showing you the real time. So you have 1 hour for 50 questions. This would be decreasing as you move forward. Now you have the first question and the choices. You have the following marks that have been given and all the 50 questions that are there. Now what you would do is, as you would go on these questions, you would have 4 tabs that would be there. These would be clear response, mark for review and next, save and next, and submit and end test. Very, very important thing. Let's say for this question, I'm not even reading the question, I'm just explaining you the procedure. So let's say I mark this A as the option. Now I believe A is not the correct option. So what I will have to do is I will have to click a clear response and I'll have to mark another. But by mistake, if I mark 2, the system would accept it here. I believe this would be the same for your NTA. So be very, very careful that you are marking only one of the check boxes and not both the check boxes. In case you are marking both the check boxes, the system might not give you error, but towards the end your marks would be deducted because you have marked 2 check boxes rather than 1 check box. So for NTA NET examination, for example, you have only one correct choice, so you have to mark only one option. Now once you have marked this, rather than going on clicking on question 2, that would be an incorrect way because by this method your answer for the first question was not saved. So what I'll have to do is I'll have to go back to the question. Let's say I click this and I have to click save and next. Only when I click save and next, my response would be saved. Very, very important to note. Many of the students do this mistake. They just mark the choice here and go and click the second question number here. But if you do that, your responses will not be saved and in the test you won't score the marks. So for example, let's say for the next question, I mark it as the answer and I mark this for review and next. Now what would happen is I would have the third question that would come up, but this would show me mark for review and next. Now when I have mark for review and next, I can come back to this question after doing all the 50 questions. That's one of the options. But an important thing is, let me come back to this question again. Now, this was a question after I have completed all the 50 questions, I come back to that question. Now, when I'm coming back to the question, I believe, okay, this is not the answer. Let me change the answer. I change this as the answer. Now, since I have changed the answer, I click save and next. Now, when I have clicked save and next, this would remain the same. So it would show me mark for review. So let's say out of the 50 questions, I have marked 5 questions for mark for review and later. Now when I'm coming back, I have already attempted this second one. I have changed my choice. I have saved it. Still, it would show me mark for review. This won't unmark. So be very, very careful under this. Once you click mark for review, there is no chance of making it unmarked for review. It will remain marked for review till the end of the test. Now, as you can see, over the time, this timer has been decreasing. So it would constantly show me how much time I have already spent. So let's say there are for your paper one, there are numerous questions, and then you have your 5 DI questions. So you leave those 5 DI questions for mark for review and next towards the end. Now you were able to complete the remaining questions in 25 minutes. You still have around 35 minutes that's left with you. So what you would do is, you would go back onto those DI questions, solve those and mark the correct answers for those questions. In case you have already marked some of the answers which were marked for review, you will have to remember it manually. The system won't do it for you for the second time. As it happened for the second case, I already changed my choice, but here it would keep showing me mark for review. Okay. What is very, very important, and I have seen numerous students through our the online session programs who have been attending the test series have shown that the students just go and simply click submit. Once you click submit, let's say I have attempted 2 questions. The third question I attempt this question as well. And once I attempt this, I move on to save and next. Rather than clicking save and next for this question, by mistake, I click submit and end test. What would happen is, my test is now over. There is no chance to go back. So once you click submit and end test, whatever number of questions you would have attempted would be the only ones that would go for your evaluation. There is no method to go back and give your test again. So practice as much as you can on the dummy module so that for the real NTA examination, you are very well prepared. You don't do the silly mistakes. 3 of the things to avoid for sure. Don't click submit and end test by mistake. Click it only once you are done with all the questions. Once you have marked the question for review, there is no case in which you can unmark it. So once you have marked 10 questions for review and you are coming back and answering those, you would have to manually remember which question has been done and which question you don't need to visit again. If I am choosing 1, 2, 3, 4 from above, my answers that I am marking will not be saved. They would be saved only in the condition when I click save and next or mark for review, save and next. So those are the 2 options in which my answers or responses would be saved. If I want to change my response, I would have to click clear response that's there. And towards the end, from those 50 questions, by looking at onto the signs, I can see which of the questions have been left unanswered, which have been marked for review. And based on the timer and my time left, I can work around those questions. So in the doorstep duty, you would find the number of questions that you had attempted, the maximum marks and the percentage that you have scored. So the time it would tell you and the topic wise performance for each section, which will be explained to you. So those are the things that are really, really important. The more you practice, the more idea you get for your NTA examination. We'll be bringing about many more sessions before your NTA examination where we would be talking about important questions, how to work around and so on and so forth. But as I said before, practicing really on computers is really, really important. Avoid any kind of silly mistakes. So the more you practice, the better it is. Have a great day ahead.